¡Hola, hola! Estoy aquí gozándome. Déjenme le bajo tantito la música porque yo ya estoy en un happy hour total. La nueva canción de Isabela Merced, ¿quién es? ¿Quién va a estar con nosotros hoy en nuestro happy hour de Latinx Now? Está buenísima, caliente Navidad. Si no la han escuchado, pónganse a eso, pero ahorita, porque... Está buenísima. Ok, quería empezar este happy hour con un poco de música para subirle un poco el tono, porque hace mucho no hacíamos un happy hour con música, así que estoy muy emocionada de nuestra invitada de hoy. Ella es lo máximo, nos va a contar todo este nuevo sencillo, además de su nuevo sencillo de Tone Cove, y va a ser una plática relajada, divertida, para hablar de todas esas cosas que nos gusta hablar a nosotros un viernes. Ya se conectó, ya está. A ver, dice connecting. Hello.
Hello.
I am obsessed.
¿Cómo estás?
Oh. I love it.
Feliz Navidad. Ahora podemos celebrar la Navidad. Ahora como que Halloween ya se acabó. Pero
así que estamos con esto. Isa, qué gusto tenerte acá en Latinx Now. ¿Cómo has estado? Pregunta obligada. Ha sido un año terrorífico, pero bueno, ¿cómo has estado?
Un poco descansada, de verdad, es que acabo de... estoy un poco enferma con un virus.
No.
De, out of nowhere, I just got sick. Es que mis sinuses, me siento muy congestionada, pero nada más, ahora me siento mejor.
Pero nada más.
Pero esta semana pasada fue horrible, también con los elections acá en los Estados Unidos, uy, pero lleno de estrés.
How have you lived this week? I want to know everything because it's like, I think we're all in the same train. And I think by now we're exhausted, but we're excited, but we're exhausted. Like, how do you feel?
Super estresada. pero como que desperté en la mañana super feliz y contenta porque Joe Biden está ganando. Mm-hmm. Y pues ahora podemos, ya puedo celebrar. I dropped my song like the other day and I didn't want to say nothing because I just like didn't think it was the right time. And this, you know how it is with like disqueras and everything. Mm-hmm. Todo está planeado. Todo tiene su date, su fecha, when they're going to drop the song ahead of time. Mm-hmm. And I was like, all right, I'm dropping this sick song that makes you want to throw it back to Christmas. And I'm like, I can't be like, so I know we're all stressed out. But, so I feel like now that he's in the lead, I mean, I'm like in a good mood now. I feel like my spirit is kind of getting a little happier. I'm getting the Christmas spirit. I'm like, all right, yeah, ahora listos. We're going to drop the song and we're gonna celebrate. And I got some more like content coming with the song.
That
and
is
also,
so...
Más música en general, like más música bilingüe, más canciones que experimentan con los sonidos y los elementos peruanos. Hablando de los elementos peruanos y la cultura peruana, aquí tengo mi... Es como que yo solo tengo 18 años, y, oh, 19 años, ahora tengo 19 años.
Okay.
No puedo tomar de happy hour, tengo mi Coca-Cola, ojalá sea suficiente, okay. Pero también tengo mi cevichito.
A ver, tenemos que hablar de la comida peruana, que es de las cosas más deliciosas que hay en la vida. Platícame qué trae ese ceviche, porque bueno, si todo el mundo no ha probado el ceviche peruano, es una cosa que te mueres de lo espectacular.
Bueno, cada país tiene su propio ceviche, sé que los mexicanos tienen su ceviche, su estilo, pero los peruanos creo que es mi favorito, y me encanta comer un cevichito en la playa, enfrente de las olas, looking at everything and enjoying the view and sweating, and just like enjoying a nice cold ceviche, pero honestly, it tastes good all year round. I'm going to tell you guys a little bit about this. So this is sweet potato. And this is corn.
Choclo.
We call it choclo here. In Peru. Because we have our own choclo. I went to a Peruvian restaurant here, and they be trying to give me that yellow corn.
No!
Yellow corn. I was like, no! I was like, can I have Peruvian choclo? And they're like, what? You got choclo. And I'm like, no, Peruvian choclo. And, you know, it's rocoto, también cebollas here. And we have, basically, like, you can have it with any fish. You can
right,
have
I love that. And you have to explain to people what rocoto is, because if people don't know, Peruvians can handle an insane amount of heat.
Porque us Mexicans, I love hot sauce, me encanta la salsa y todo, pero cuando me dijeron, voy a ponerle rocoto a tu ceviche, dije, dale, está bien, soy mexicana, lo aguanto todo. ¡Madre mía! Eso está fuerte.
Amo el rocoto y como que ya todavía estoy un poco enferma, eso es lo único que me da sabor, eso es lo único que me hace sentir feliz o me hace sentir algo. And rocoto is, honestly, we have our own selection of peppers. Basically, it's un ají, and ají is a special Peruvian pepper. I think in Drake and Josh, they called it the Peruvian puff pepper. And everybody pregunta, what's the Peruvian puff pepper? Because that's the only, like, knowledge that, like, my kids my age have of Peru. Other than Frank Sinatra, fly me to Peru. And so I be telling them, oh, it's ají, and I get them the crema de ají, I show them the rocoto, it's just like the little peppers, the crushed like red peppers. And then they have my favorite, honestly, like there's different ajis. My dog is just sitting here at the table with me as if she's going to get something to eat.
Oh, please, please put her in the camera. Put him, show us your dogs.
Tengo tres perritos, dos perritas y un perrito que tiene tres patas. Esta es mi canelita. A ver. Se llama Canela.
Canela.
She's getting bigger. She was a little baby. She's a little baby. Tiene una bebé. She's so sweet. She looks like a mini Pluto. I gotta put you down low. She's trying to eat my yuca frita.
Oh no, no. You have to show us. I got interrupted by the dogs because I'm obsessed with dogs. But show us what else you have there.
Of course, we could do a whole segment on the dogs. Let's just do another Instagram live. Oh, she's
amazing.
Let's do it. Yuca frita with ají. Bueno, crema de ají. This is more like a creamy version of ají.
Right, it's not as spicy, right?
Ají amarillo, yeah. It's so freaking good, though. It's like creamy and it tastes good. Like, you just dip it in here, and you just... Oh, my God, my dog is dying for some. Sorry, baby.
Oh, and me too. I'm just like your dog. I'm watching you just like your dog. Yo no sé por qué no pedí yo de un restaurante peruano, porque es de mis comidas favoritas, de verdad. Bueno, en lo que comemos comida peruana, hay que divertirnos un poco. Y cuéntanos, quiero que me cuentes cómo fue trabajar, por ejemplo, con Dana Paula. Ya que estamos hablando de peruano y mexicano, quiero que me cuentes de eso.
La Dana es una reina. También una linda persona, porque hablé con ella sobre Instagram. Conocí a la Dana Paula sobre Instagram, como todas las amistades virtuales en 2020.
Literally.
Y bueno, me sentí súper nerviosa hablando con ella porque yo soy súper fan de su trabajo en Elite y su música y su carrera en general. Y pues ella muy linda hablando conmigo sobre Instagram. Y mandé mi canción Don't Go porque tuve la idea durante la cuarentena para hacer un feature o un duet de la canción. And she was like so down. Inmediatamente me mandó su versión de la canción, su verso. Y, oh my God, me enamoré de la letra. Like, if you guys listen to the song,
her so voice is
crazy. She's like Latina. Oye, no, don't fight. they're trying to fight over food that they're never gonna have.
Oh my God.
Pero bueno, she says, deja de buscar alemanas latinas sabor peruana mexicana. And I was like, damn, girl. I'm like,
damn. Damn. Oh,
good. Oh, yeah. Yeah, and she with that. So much advice, like with guys and stuff, un montón de consejos de la vida, sobre la vida, porque ella tiene más experiencia que yo en este industria, pero también con los chicos.
Oh, okay, so now we got into a topic that I like. All right, tell me what she told you, because I need the down low on that, porque yo no he tenido nada de éxito, amiga.
Bro, a mí no me dijo nada de su vida.
No, pero ¿qué consejos te dio?
Oh, qué consejos. Well, at the time, I was, like, freshly heartbroken. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I don't really be dating a lot because... Oh, yeah! Cálmense! I don't really be dating a lot because boys, frankly, are just, like, a waste of time, I find, especially at my age, you know?
Yes.
Y maduros no tienen experiencia, and they don't have money. They don't have money. I be traveling a lot. They need to have the money to meet me where I am because I'm on location. I'm filming. I'm making music, I'm doing whatever. Y'all can't be broke and making me pay for your plane ticket. So I don't date a lot. And so when I do date a lot, I'm giving you the golden ticket to the Willy Wonka Chocolate Factory.
Yes,
you cannot be wasting my time. But all the dudes, they cheat on me. They cheat on me. They like it's a game. Like it's like their career or something. Three times I've cheated on. So basically she was just giving me advice on that. She's like, time cures. Basically try to make sure I don't become a pessimist when it comes to la romancia. Whatever, it's fine. Like I'll be okay. I just need some time. I think I'm gonna be single for like 3 years.
Don't even plan, just live your life and let it flow because you never know. I mean, of course you're 18 years old, y yo te voy a decir una cosa también. Cuando yo tenía 18 years old, because now I'm getting older, pero yo también dije, no voy a tener novia ahorita, me voy a dedicar a vivir, a gozar y a disfrutar, y de repente uno que otro se aparece, you have your fun, and you fall in love, and all those things. Pero me encanta que te haya dado esos consejos, Dana Paola. Y,
Sobre WhatsApp.
No, yo ya necesito conseguir su teléfono porque tengo yo también un par de consejos que necesito. Cuéntanos cómo pasas un viernes normalmente.
Oye, mi vida es muy boring.
No seas mentirosa.
No, te lo juro que es que, bueno, recién, sí, specifically lately, yes, my life is very boring because la coronavirus, esta pandemia, yo me quedo en casa la mayoría del tiempo, pero si no, paso mucho tiempo con mis amigos. Tengo un montón de amigos que son muy talentosos. Todos mis amigos tienen un talento, pues, más insane, like, whether they're, like, super smart, and they be like, chess masters, or what? They're writers, and they just write insane music, and they sing. But my life is boring, I will tell you that. I really, honestly, my career is probably the most interesting thing about me. I just be with my dog, watching Netflix. With my mom.
I feel you. Es yo también. Yo también soy idéntica. Y como dicen aquí, I feel like I'm having like a girl's dinner, and I love it. Y en lo que comes ese delicioso ceviche, le hicimos unas preguntas a los fans que querían saber de ti, and these are all fun questions. It's about like your favorite things. Are you ready?
Dale.
Okay, dale. ¿Cuál es tu canción favorita del último mes?
La canción de mi amigo se llama Omar Apollo. Okay. Y una canción que se llama Want You Around, pero el you es literally a u. Okay. Check it out. Very fun, very good, very sexy.
That's right on my playlist. Who was your crush growing up?
Oof. I used to think it was, so I watched High School Musical, and I was like, you think I'd be obsessed with Zac Efron? No, I was obsessed with Vanessa Hudgens. I was just on both Zac Efron and Vanessa Hudgens. It was very hard for me. It was very confusing, but very entertaining nonetheless.
They're awesome. Mm-hmm. ¿Cuál es tu postre favorito, your favorite dessert?
Bueno, depende, porque me encantan los fresas. La fruta es mi favorito. Like, I love that fruit dessert, pero como que tengo los alfajores aquí en mi mesa. Los alfajores son mis favoritos. Listen, we're having a Peruvian theme today, porque también for the main course, I got lomo saltado.
Oh, no. That is my favorite dish.
Am I making you hungry? Are you hungry right now?
Oh, no. I am worse than canela. I am canela right now. Canela right now at this second, and everyone connected here probably the same, because you are having like a Peruvian feast, and I'm here with like a flower, and I have no around me.
Start eating the flowers.
I'm gonna start eating these plants porque no tengo comida alrededor, y tú estás haciendo un festín de una de mis comidas favoritas del mundo. So okay, favorite dessert. So let's go with fruit, but really alfajores, because oh my god. Who makes the best lomo saltado for you?
Bueno, sé que mi tío makes the best ceviche. Pero creo que mi mami. Mi tía Gloria hace el mejor lomo saltado.
¿Y cuál es el secreto para que un lomo saltado te quede así auténtico como el de Perú?
Bueno, los ingredientes básicos como el, obviously the ají, the more ají that you add on top of it. A la parrilla, you gotta do a la parrilla. You gotta do it with the big ass thing where you flip it on the fire.
So many things I need to buy just to make like a perfect lomo saltado. And I guess that when I get them all, they're never gonna be as delicious. So here in Miami, thankfully, we have delicious Peruvian restaurants.
Oh, you're Miami. Que...
Sí.
Oh my God, I love Miami. I literally wrote a song about Miami. ¿Sabes? Tengo una canción en mi EP, the EP is called Mi Mejor Mitad, pero se llama Todo Está Bien. Escribí la canción en Miami, okay. De Miami. It's like a love letter to Miami, because that's the way it makes me feel. I love Miami.
That's awesome. So what's your favorite memory in Miami?
Oof. Which one should I pick? I just remember I was alone. I was alone on the beach, and the water was so nice and so clear. I mean, when is it not clear? But I like taking my dog on the beach there. Pluto loves it there. It's his favorite beaches in the whole world. But I just like being alone there, and I went swimming. I went really, really, really far out. Probably shouldn't have done that. Solita. Cantando y relajando y nadando en el océano. And I was in the Bell Harbor area, I think. And It was just so beautiful. I love being alone. I love it. Like, I spent my last birthday alone, and it made me wonder why I don't spend every birthday alone. Why I haven't spent every birthday alone. It's just so nice. It's like,
I like it too. You know, I think it's one of those times that when we're young and we're used to being with our friends and with all these things, and then we have opportunities to be alone and to really enjoy ourselves. O sea, como que no solamente es estar sola, sino es como que disfrutar tu soledad. Y hoy llega un momento en el que me encanta, o sea, llegar a mi casa, estar haciendo mis cosas, como tú dices, escribir música, cantar, bailar. Digo, yo no escribo música ni canto, pero bailo. Y sí. Me la paso súper bien.
Es que creo que también que los jóvenes sienten un poco de presura para estar con sus amigos, su familia, en su cumple, pero de verdad no, you don't owe that to anybody, and being alone doesn't mean being lonely, you know?
Totally, and that's the difference that we have to mark. Okay, otra pregunta que tengo por aquí. A ver, preguntan tus fans, ¿cuáles son las cualidades que buscas en un hombre que sea ideal para ti? So let's say all these idiot boys that cheat on you, let's forget about them. If you could write a list of like 5 things that they have to have, ¿qué tienen que ser?
Well, they are men, so we can't give them too much credit.
I love this. This is my favorite happy hour that I've done ever, okay? Let me tell you.
No! Oh my God. Yes. I'm having so much fun.
Because you're so much fun, and I think that people are enjoying it, porque siempre es como preguntas, 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 and you're like, so me das unas respuestas tan padres que todo lo que yo tenía planeado, it's like going to like a so much better conversation, honestly.
Es muy linda, gracias. Ojalá podemos hacer otro conversación, otro happy hour when I'm in Peru or something, we can actually drink, okay?
Oh, yes.
That'll be even crazy. I don't think we'll ever get any questions done.
No questions. We'll just trash men an hour for an hour.
My requirement. Bueno, no matter who it is, I think you just gotta like dogs, because I have 3. Tiene que tener una buena relación con sus padres, específicamente con su mami, porque creo que a lot of these boys be having mommy issues and they're bringing it to the relationship, and I'm the one who has to deal with it. I'm not your mother. I'm not going to take care of you. You got to take care of yourself. What are you bringing to the table? I'm not going to take care of you. I'm not your mother. So
I love it.
Y la tercera.
And you're giving me life. I'm okay. The best thing I've ever heard.
Y la tercera. Tienen que respetar que yo tengo mi propia carrera. Y no deben estar celosos. No deben estar intimidated de mi carrera. Y como que yo soy una persona muy independiente. Y yo voy a pasar mucho tiempo con otros artistas y personas y hombres en particular. And they need to be confident in themselves, not to be intimidated by that.
Because great that's girl power forever. Sí, que no se hagan intimidated.
Don't be insecure. Love yourself.
All right, you get 2 more.
Dos más preguntas o requirements?
No, 2 more requirements. 2 more requirements.
Okay. they must cook Peruvian food in particular.
There you go, guys. Ya vieron lo que está por ahí. Lomo saltado. Ceviche.
Porque yo no puedo cocinar. Yo no puedo cocinar. I don't cook. I don't clean. Cardi B. But I do clean. I do clean, but I wait till the last minute to do so.
You and I both.
Y también tiene que saber. He needs to know how to dance.
Oh, so important. I don't know why guys, like, they're scared to dance. Not Latinos, porque hay latinos que saben bailar súper bien, pero como que si son de otro lado del mundo, es como, ay, yo no bailo. Los mexicanos no les gusta bailar casi nada.
Sí, wait, really? Es que creo que es una cosa de like, machismo, porque creo que ahora, en esos días modernos, los chicos creen que bailar es algo muy femenino. Like, they don't think it's very masculine to dance. Entonces, no quieren aprender porque sienten incómodos con esa idea que somebody will think that they're it's very feminine to do this or feminine.
No, but you know what? There's nothing sexier que llegue un hombre y que te diga vamos a bailar y que sea como pam 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 pam.
Somebody can throw me around. I literally was at a wedding once and this random guy was like, ¿quieres bailar? I was actually in Peru actually, okay, and I was like, okay, sure. And he was like not even cute and he wasn't even that like. He was a lot older than me, so it wasn't like flirting and shit, but he was such a good dancer. I'm telling you, my feet didn't touch the ground for 1 minute. I was being thrown up in the air and just swung around. I was so scared for my life, but I was also excited. I was like, this is what it should feel like.
Totally. It's so exciting. It's so exciting when someone like makes you feel like that. Yo sabes que, entre que me está dando hambre, me está dando ir a bailar y estoy aquí sola con mi planta.
Yo pensé que íbamos a comer juntas. Yo pensé que esto era like, I don't know, like a Thanksgiving, like Friendsgiving moment.
You know what? You are the one doing it, right?
Perdóname, celos.
Honestly, this is so much fun. Okay, otra pregunta que te mandaron por aquí es, ¿cuál es tu ritmo favorito para bailar? Now that we're talking about dancing.
Bueno, creo que me siento más familiar con salsa, siento más cómoda, hay no más pasos en salsa, porque mi tío es un salsero, y todos los peruanos son salseros en general, they love salsa, pero bachata a veces, that's really easy, it's just ta, 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 ta,
yeah,
pero quiero aprender, I want to learn like, I don't know, what do I want to learn? I just want to get better at salsa, I think, because salsa is really sexy, and there's, hay un montón de pasos, un montón de diferentes estilos, depending what, like, country or, like, whatever, and I think that would be really, really cool, para poder, you know, show off some skills, some moves in the bodas de mis tías, I don't know.
Oh, yes, that's why you have to learn salsa, because when the weddings come, it's like you have a dance floor where, like, clubs and parties don't have anymore, so... Cuando estás en una boda y hay una pista, es como, prepárense para todo lo que aprendí. And there you get to show.
It's like,
now we just need the guys. We just need the guys so we can dance with us. And if
no,
not,
no, necesitamos las dos. You be no Patrick Sotera. Swayze. I can be Patrick no Swayze.
No, because I am like 5'10", so I think I'll crush you.
Okay, look at this. Look at this. I got it. I got a shirt on about... the economy. I'm basically
packing. You got it. No, I'll promise you that when you're in Miami, I'm gonna make like this whole story. Voy a hacer un reportaje completo de tú y yo bailando como Patrick Swayze. You'll see. I'll make that happen.
Porfa, okay.
Last two questions que mandaron por acá. ¿Cómo fue la primera vez que te reconocieron en la calle un fan? Like, you are such a cool girl. Eres tan relajada. ¿Cómo fue cuando llegaron en la calle y dijiste, oh my God, I'm kind of famous?
Uf, creo que fue durante un trip a Disneyland en Los Ángeles. Disneyland en Los Ángeles. Unas chicas que en ese tiempo, I was in Nickelodeon y ellas me reconocieron y hablamos por un ratito, es que I was just very surprised that they knew me, so when they came up to me, still to this day, cuando gente me reconoce en la calle, yo me pongo súper confundida, un poco incómoda, I don't know, it's like, you know me, but I don't know you, and like, you're talking like you know me, but I don't know you, and it's like, I know it's like a moment that's supposed to be about like them meeting me, but I'm like, what's that, like, what's your name, it's just, I don't know, I'm really bad at it. You would think I'm, like, chill about it, but I just get, like, really weird. Muy, muy shy. Like,
really? I would never think that.
I don't know. You know what? They probably don't think it. They're probably, oh my cool God, ratchet. You? They're probably not even.
You cannot be shy.
No, I get shy around people I like, around around Jason Momoa and fans.
Oh my god. Oh my god. You cannot compare that, okay? What would you do if Jason Momoa comes and he's like the best salsa dancer ever?
Oh my god, me muero, pero sé que no puede bailar porque hice una película con él el año pasado, se llama Sweet Girl, Dulce Niña. It's coming out Netflix la próximo año y el próximo año 2021. But it's a little promo. But no, sé que no puede bailar porque salimos un par de veces después del set, después de grabar, filmar la película y yo le he enseñado un montón de pasos de papi, de mi video musical de papi y otros bailes como like de Beyoncé, Britney Spears. I was teaching him and he was like, he would just like watch me. He was like, bro, I could just watch you dance all day. And I was like, thank you. And I would just keep dancing.
O sea, no puedo creer lo que me estás diciendo. You are teaching Jason Momoa dance moves, girl.
No, oh todavía no puedo bailar. Todavía no puedo bailar. It was more for me. It was like, I just like having him watch me. I like the attention. But you know, I taught him a few little paths. I taught him a few things here and there. Oh, it's just God. Like, but yeah.
You're hilarious. O sea, you are the funniest. This is the best happy hour I've had. I'm not lying. Everyone here is like, I see people from my job that are connected. They're like, oh my god, I'm so entertained. This is the best thing ever.
Okay. Qué divertido. Oh my god, I'm so happy.
Yes, I'm happy for you. Okay, so before we go, because we have 5 minutes left, cuéntanos qué proyectos tienes, because this has been like the best girl conversation, but I really want to know more about your projects y qué va a salir y qué viene.
Mi carrera, pues, ya, yeah, bueno, mi película con Jason Momoa, también tengo una película animada, pero no puedo hablar mucho de eso porque todavía no ha salido nada en los news, pero el cast, the cast though, bro, that cast is crazy, and I'm leading it, and it's a DreamWorks movie, like Shrek, like Trolls, like, it's crazy.
Oh my god.
You know, ¿qué más? Oh, más música, pues.
Obvio.
Tengo un proyecto que viene muy pronto, pero también tengo mi canción de Navidad y un video para mi canción de Navidad que viene muy pronto. Un montón de cosas, de verdad. Más trabajo con los charities. Pero bueno, like, I'm having a good time. I'm having a good time and I'm single. Don't forget
it. Are enjoying life. De verdad, eres como una fuente de energía de que I want to go out and just, like, live life like you do. And you're like, man, no, I don't need anyone. I'll just dance. I'll just keep on working. I'll just have fun. De verdad que eres una niña lindísima. I can't wait for you to be in Miami because I'm going to plan, like, the best segment, reportaje, story about you. I promise.
Y después vamos a ir a bailar un salsa. I miss Miami, bro. I haven't been there in so long. Bueno, gracias a la pandemia, pero
no.
Muy pronto nos vemos y bueno, we're going to have a good time. That's all I can say. I know we're going to have a good time. I can say
we are going to have a good time. So enjoy the rest of your dinner. I'm going to go ahead and order some. I was going to say the restaurant, but I was like, okay, I'm not going to plug it in here. Porque no me da nada. Pero it's...
like, give me a discount, please.
I was going to say a restaurant. And I was like, no, maybe not here. Isa, thank you so much for everyone there. Check her out. Follow her. Obviously, you follow her. Follow Latinx now. And... let's get ready for the weekend because it's going to be a weekend to remember, don't you think?
Yeah, when we win, when Trump gets kicked out.
Oh my God.
He's going to get kicked out. The big bad wolf. The big bad wolf for the God.
Oh my God. Canela, say goodbye to the Latinx Now fam.
Bye. Oh my
God. Bye, everyone.
Okay.
Bye, Isa. I'll see you soon.
Gracias a mis fans y todos mis seguidores. Mis nuevos seguidores, ojalá we'll be together here for a long time. Y un placer, un gran placer conocerte. I'm a feast right now. And I watch the show. Yeah. Any good shows? Any good show suggestions or anything to watch?
Did you see Emily in Paris?
No, I didn't. I did not see Ooh. It. I heard mixed reviews. I didn't know.
There's mixed reviews, but I liked it. I watched it in like 7 hours straight. Así que esa es una buena que te recomiendo por ahí.
Okay, I recommend that one for you too. I go on for we'll you see. Too. The Queen's Gambit.
Oh, is it the one, the chess?
I literally learned chess yesterday because I love that show so bad.
They told me it was amazing, so that's a really good one. And then if you haven't seen Love Life,
de Argentina, I think too.
Sí, I no, y esa me dijeron que está buenísima.
Latina, we love to support them. We love to see it.
We love Latinas. Latinas are the best in the world. So that's it. I had the best time. Honestly, I'm gonna repeat it again. Best happy hour ever. And Yuvia, who's there, who works with me, and Lucy, who's there, who works with me, they're all been saying the same thing. So hopefully, we'll have another one soon. And then for the next one, we'll talk about dogs.
Bueno, saludos a todo el equipo de Latinx Now. Gracias a ustedes. I had so much fun. Thank you so much for making my day.
All right. Bye. See you soon.
Bye. Love you guys. Bye. How do I... I'm going to turn this off.
Bueno, como pueden ver, qué cosa más divertida. Hace mucho no me divierto tanto en un happy hour y por eso tienen que conectarse con nosotros todos los viernes en estas happy hours de Latinx Now. Disfruten su fin de semana, vayan a descansar, se quiten las noticias, seamos felices y nos vemos el sábado a las 12:30 de la noche por Telemundo para que vean Latinx Now. Es un super show y ya saben, todos los días en YouTube y me pueden seguir en @alixaspe. Bye.